And what is up, guys? Andrew from the Den Men here, and today I want to do a fun little ranking of every house in Skyrim. The houses that you can get are quite unique aesthetically and are a little homestead for the Dragonborn. Getting the houses themselves is easy in nature and is a little side thing to do in between quests, a place where you can rest and relax and drop off unnecessary collectibles and to make your home look a little better. Before we start, I just want to say that this is my list, so if you have your own favorite house, drop a comment and let me know what it is. I will also not be including the houses that you build in the Hearthfire DLC, because there can be a lot of combinations for them, and the builds are the same for all three spots. But without further ado, let's jump right into it. Coming in at our number 6 spot, we have Honeyside, which is set in the town of Riften. The problem for me with Honeyside is that it is too bland. It feels like your normal, run-of-the-mill cottage on the water. They definitely were going for that vibe of a lakeside house when creating Honeyside, because it is really small compared to the other homes on this list. For what it has in such a tight space, it makes up for with the decorations in the house itself. There are two floors to this homestead. You have the main floor, which houses your bedroom and living area, and then the cellar, where you have your alchemy table and enchanting table. There is also a room in the cellar that has no use and nothing can be put there, so it feels like a misused opportunity to add an armory or something of that kind. But other than that, the weapon racks and mannequins will let you spice up the house a little bit, but they feel just out of the way compared to other spots on our list. Overall, the house itself is more of a vacation home, and if you were thinking of having this as your first house, I would recommend buying a different place, because Honeyside cannot compete with other houses on the list, and that is why it is our number 6 house in Skyrim. At our number 5 spot, we have Breeze Home, which is situated in the town of Whiterun. Breeze Home is the most basic house in Skyrim, but it gets extra points for being the first house the player got, and I'm sure it holds a special place in all of our hearts. There is nothing wrong with Breeze Home, except for the lack of mannequins and weapon racks to show off your armor and weapons. The home itself is bigger than Honeyside and has a lot more decorations to it. Breeze Home feels like it is filled and a lot going on within the house with the space provided. It has two floors, same as Honeyside, except Breeze Home doesn't have a cellar. The first floor contains your dining room and the choice of either an alchemy room or children's bedroom. The second floor consists of a bedroom for your house, Carl, and a main bedroom for you to sleep with a common area in between the two rooms. Overall, Breeze Home is the most basic house on the list, and you can never go wrong with acquiring it. At our number 4 spot, we have the most expensive house on our list, Proudspire Manor, and you can find it in Solitude. Proudspire Manor feels the most modern of all the houses and very civilized, and it definitely fits the whole vibe of Solitude. The house itself is very spread out, and the lighting within the house is very pleasing with its windows. A big negative for me with this house is how the mannequins and weapon racks are limited and out of the way from viewing. This is a big turnoff, because there is definitely enough space for there to fit 2 or 3 more mannequins, so you can add your own design for the house. But the rooms themselves are very decorated, and I really like how they brought in some foliage to give the house a more lived-in vibe. There are 3 floors to Proudspire Manor, which is a plus in my opinion. The main floor consists of a dining room and the entryway. The top floor mostly is the main bedroom, but it does have a mini dining area leading up to the bedroom. Then there's the cellar, which has your enchanting and alchemy tables with mannequins and weapon racks to spice up the room a bit. There is room in the cellar that is just wasted space, so I would have liked to see an armory or even a second bedroom to make Proudspire Manor even more decorated. Coming in at our number 3 spot, we have the Dwemer House of Markarth, Valindril Hall. The house design in its entirety is the most unique in the game. It is that of the Dwemer, and in my opinion, the Dwemer design gives a feel to the house next to none. It definitely matches the vibe of Markarth, with the city also being of Dwemer design. There is only one floor to Valyndral Hall, but this doesn't lessen design of it at all, because when you first walk in the entryway, it really sets the tone for the home, and is the best in the game. When you walk up the stairs, you are greeted with a large room with a dining table in the center, and a fire burning to the right. The lighting in the home is perfect, because you feel like you are underground, and there's just the right amount of candles and fires. The first room on your left is where your alchemy table is, and the second room would be where the enchanting table lies. And these rooms are pretty similar, except for the fact the enchanting room has weapon racks to customize the room in more ways. When you continue on past the large dining area, you are shown the main dining room with a fire burning in the middle, and above there are Dwemer pipes that continue the aesthetic of the hall. The room to your right is where your housecarl sleeps, and is pretty standard compared to the other rooms. The main bedroom is the one to the left of the dining room, and is small in design, but makes up for it with a wonderful aesthetic. The weapon racks and mannequins are spread out throughout the house, and that is what all of the home should do, because you see your own design throughout the whole house. Overall, the house itself is one of the better ones in the game, and I recommend it if you want a very good looking home at a low price. And next on our list, we have the second best house in Skyrim, and this one being set in the town of Ravenrock, Severin Manor. I really enjoy this homestead, especially since it is the only one you can acquire in Solstheim. It is unique in that it takes a whole questline to acquire it, and no need for purchasing and upgrading the house. There is a lot of stuff going on in the house, with rooms we've never seen before in any other house on this list. Starting off, there are two floors to the house, but the top floor doesn't have much except for a couple chairs and a fire. Where it gets good is the bottom floor, and our first room on the right is a whole blacksmithing station which we have never seen in any other house. This is very accessible seeing how it is inside the home itself. You move over to the first room on the left and you have a second bedroom which is pretty standard all things considered, but it does have a garden in it and it is a very large room. The next two rooms are the alchemy and enchanting rooms. I like the enchanting room a lot because it is out in the open and there are plenty of weapon racks to show off your collection of gear. The alchemy room doesn't have the same uniqueness to it, but that is like most alchemy rooms in the game. Where the house really shines is the main bedroom. When you first walk in, there are four mannequins that give the room a lot to customize. The mannequins are spaced perfectly and in just the right spots so that you can see them all as you enter the bedroom. There are also plenty of weapon racks and display cases, so that is a major plus for me. I like the Dunmer architecture of the home, which gives it a very unique design. Overall, it is one of my favorite homes in the game, not only for the home itself, but how you acquire it is a big positive, and that is why it is number 2 on our list. Coming in at our number 1 spot, the best house in Skyrim by far, Hyarim, set in the snowy city of Windhelm. This house has everything you can think of. Let's start off with the first floor. As you enter the house, you walk into an open dining room with plenty of space. The room to the right is the kitchen, which we have never seen in a home up to now, so that is a major plus. Continuing on from the dining room, we have a space that is used as a child's room, which is great that you don't have to replace something with it. The best part of the whole house is the hidden room behind the wardrobe that doubles as an alchemy and enchanting room. Not only does the room itself look great, it is hidden from the rest of the house, which is by far one of the best things of any house in the game. Moving on to the second floor, you have the best representation of what a trophy room should be. The mannequins are spread apart perfectly with weapon racks and cases to fill in the spaces. It has the best viewing pleasure of any house in the game and a lot of customizability. There are two other rooms in Hyarim. The one to the right is the second bedroom for your housecarl, which is standard for a second bedroom. The main bedroom, on the other hand, is large and decorated very well. Another positive to this home is the fact that you are able to go into the home beforehand to investigate the murders in the quest Blood on Ice. Everything about this house is a plus, and I highly recommend buying it if you have never before and is no doubt the best house in Skyrim. All houses in Skyrim have their own look to it, so at the end of the day, it comes down to personal preference on which one you like the best. But that's the end of the ranking every house in Skyrim, guys. I want to continue doing rankings of many other topics in Skyrim, so if you enjoyed the video, leave a like and comment any further rankings you guys want to see, and I'll see you all next time.